So, who won? Who was left for roadkill? And what is this feud doing to CNBC's reputation? Joining us now in Los Angeles, Stephanie Miller, host of the nationally syndicated Stephanie Miller radio show. And here in Washington, David Zurich, television critic for the Baltimore Sun, who writes the Zeon TV blog, and Tucker Carlson, commentator and a contributor to the Daily Beast. All right, Stephanie Miller, let's face it, Jim Cramer was playing on Jon Stewart's home court, so how do you score this basic cable showdown?
Well, this is a technical term, Howard, but kind of an ass-kicking is, I think, what took place.
Who
there?
Did the kicking?
I mean, something. Jon Stewart, for sure. I mean, something has gone awry in our country, Howard, when, you know, a financial guy is screaming and throwing pies on television and a comedian is giving really cogent economic analysis. I think there's only one thing that's going to come from this, and I think we have to look to Carrot Top to solve the Middle East crisis.
All right, Tucker Carlson.
Hillary Clinton, for the good of the country, must step down, Howard.
Tucker Carlson, I want to play a little bit more and get your opinion on the other side. You've tangled with Jon Stewart. We'll get to that a little later in the show. Let's play another bite from that interview on The Daily Show.
I understand you want to make finance entertaining, but it's not a game. And I, when I watch that, I can't tell you how angry that makes me.
John, don't you want guys like me who have been in it to show the shenanigans? What else can I do? I'm not Eric Severat. I'm not Edward R. Murrow. I'm a guy trying to do an entertainment show about business for people to watch.
Did Jon Stewart prove his case against Jim Cramer?
Can you imagine Jim Cramer sitting there and taking a sanctimonious lecture from Jon Stewart? Yes. I mean, Cramer was craven and sweaty and pathetic. I'm sure his wife was ashamed of his behavior, the butt-sniffing he gave Jon Stewart. But Jon Stewart, let's be honest, this was a partisan attack. He went after Cramer the moment Cramer criticized Obama's budget. That was the mortal sin. That's what kicked off this entire feud.
You don't buy the notion that Jon Stewart is angry. I mean, Jon Stewart's been...
Of course he's angry.
And he's angry
about a lot of things.
Right.
But look, was Jim Cramer the only analyst to call it wrong, to come up with stupid stock picks? Of course not. He criticized Obama's budget, and that's what started this. Because in the end... Jon Stewart is a partisan hack.
All right, we'll come back to that point, but I want to get David Zurich. And I want to play one more piece of tape, which shows Jim Cramer. A lot of people were surprised that he didn't fight back very much. Let's roll that.
Big fan of the show. I'm sorry. You're absolutely right. I don't want to personalize it. I'm trying. I got a lot of things wrong. What else can I do? I'll do that. I wish I had done a better job.
Howie, he was pathetic. It just got more and more pathetic. If you looked at the body language, almost every shot, you had Stewart coming over the desk and Cramer going like this through the whole thing. You know, he really thought, I think he came on thinking he could do a showbiz schmooze and get out of this and it would be some jokes and they'd be out of there. And Stewart set him up in some ways where he said, oh, there was just some pies being thrown and some schmutz get on your suit, blah, blah, blah. And I think Cramer thought it's going to be okay. But then when he said, well, you know, guys make good calls and bad calls. And I think that something he said maybe set him off, or maybe he was just doing a brilliant piece of argumentation, Stewart, the way he set it up. But first he said, this is not entertainment, you know, this is, you've abrogated any journalistic responsibility. But by the end of it, he was accusing them, CNBC and Cramer, of dishonesty, of knowing there was this background.
Yeah, I was really surprised that Cramer said, we didn't know, and if I had known, I would have blown the whistle. And by the way, Jim Cramer did criticize CNBC's Rick Santelli for that rant against President Obama. That got cut out in the editing. Stephanie, does Jon Stewart try to have it both ways? Hey, I'm just a comic, I'm an entertainer, we're here to have a good time, but here's my serious social commentary.
Well, if he does have it both ways, he does it very well. And Tucker, I think you're wrong on that. This did not start because he criticized, because Cramer criticized Obama. This started, you know, he was just doing a rant against CNBC. Jim Cramer was included. It was because of Santelli going off on the American homeowner that Stewart took them to task. So I don't think it had anything to do with Obama or that policy.
Well, Santelli wasn't going off on the American homeowner, of course. He was going off on Obama and Obama's policies. And that's the point here. Look, Jon Stewart is a political player. He's a partisan. He is speaking on behalf of the Democratic Party, and in so doing, becoming, I think, I mean, he's smart and he's talented, But he's becoming so self-serious and sanctimonious that it's just a matter of time before he becomes unfunny. I mean, this is the fate of all kinds of comedians. This is the fate of Lenny Bruce, and it will happen. You watch.
Honestly, Tucker, with all due respect, I think it's a horrible mistake to look at this through that kind of ideological prism. You know, back in October on this show, we were going after Kramer for this. This, and what we were going after him for is essentially what Stewart talked about. It is that the job of journalism is to give citizens information that they can use to make good decisions, sound decisions about their life. CNBC, Kramer, Santelli, that whole crew is doing the opposite in a time of crisis. They're giving us bad information. Thank God Stewart went after
it. Hold on. They're not just giving us bad information. You can take videotape and say, they were wrong on this, Kramer was wrong on Bear Stearns, but they also do a lot of reporting. You seem to object.
Yes.
You seem to object when anybody wants to have a good time or jazz things up to make people watch. It's television!
It's television, Howie, but really, this is... Would you not say we are in a time of crisis and people are looking to us as the press? This is the other reason the people don't like us in the press. They say, oh, I'm going to come and get some information, and instead they get clown show Kramer up there.
I think
it is so dangerous right now in this democracy for us not to be able to know where we can get that information in the press. Wait. And obviously you would turn to a financial news network in an economic crisis.
Wait a second. I'm not defending CNBC or its bad calls, but you are not even commenting upon the demagoguery of Jon Stewart, who's posing as if CNBC is single-handedly responsible for this recession, which it is not. You will never see Jon Stewart criticize the economic policies of this administration. He is acting on their behalf. He is looking through an ideological lens as he sees
it. I want to come back to...
Excuse me.
Go ahead, Stephanie.
Excuse me, Tucker. May I just say, first of all, Jon Stewart is very, very funny. He is not losing his funny. You know, best comedy is based on truth, and he is telling the truth, and he's being really funny doing it.
Are you serious?
This is very serious, says Jon. This is very serious.
Oh, lighten up,
He's
pal.
Still very funny.
Okay. Well, that's not funny.
I think we need to put on the table what Jon Stewart did. Actually, he came on this show in 2002 and he did a rant about CNN and you're the news, don't be entertainment, you've got to help us. And then he went on your old show, Crossfire, the now defunct CNN program Crossfire. Let's play a little bit of that from 2004.
It's not honest. What you do is not honest. What you do is partisan hackery. The interesting thing that I have is you have a responsibility to the public discourse. And
you
fail
need to get a job at a
miserably,
school, I think.
You need to go to one.
So you've been on the receiving end of a Jon Stewart lecture, clearly.
Yeah.
And does that color your view at all of his perspicacity?
It's all the same. I mean, to call me a partisan hack is ludicrous.
Well, you're
a partisan. I am the least partisan person I know. I have zero interest in party politics. Zero interest. I spent half my life attacking Republicans. I'm an ideologue. Truly, I have ideas that are distinct from partisan politics. Jon Stewart, that was the same year that he had John Kerry on his show, one of the very few people to be able to interview John Kerry, and sniffed his throne, sucked up to him. Questions like, why are you so wonderful? Why are they so mean to you? He's the one who's abrogating his responsibility to inform his viewers, who, by the way, actually believe him.
Hold on. There's no question that Jon Stewart, in terms of his personal views, falls on the liberal side of the spectrum. But now that Obama's president, I want to play this for you, Stephanie Miller. He's been making some jokes about the new president. Let's roll a little bit of that.
All right, Hope, there you go. Nice agenda. Solid, confident, definitely.
Healthcare reform cannot wait. It must not wait, and it will not wait another year.
Okay, easy there, fella. Let's just keep our feet on the ground here. Let's just...
Okay. Cure for cancer in our time.
Okay, we cut that off too soon. I didn't get to the joke. The joke was he took exception to the Obama's notion about a cure for cancer in our time. So, Stephanie, do you see Jon Stewart as somebody who is just, keeping the Democratic administration off limits and that his comedy is one-sided, as Tucker suggests?
I don't think so. I mean, I think that they, you know, the Daily Show has historically taken on both sides and made fun of both sides. He clearly, you know, is on one side of the ideological divide. But Tucker, you know, I've spent time with you and you are delightful, may I just say. I would not use the word hack about you, but you hosted the right side of a Crossfire show. You're saying you're not a partisan.
No, I was the right winger. I wasn't there speaking on behalf of the stupid Republican Party, which I've never been involved in. I'm not my team, right or wrong.
But for you to call
I believe in certain ideas.
Jon Stewart partisan, you know,
No, I think Jon Stewart is dishonest. And by the way, I also think he's a sacred cow. There's nobody who has the huevos to attack Jon Stewart because he's too popular. The press sucks up to him like I've never seen any. It's like Oprah. Jon Stewart, you know, all the kids watch Jon Stewart. He's brilliant. I would like to see somebody have the stones to come out and say, Jon Stewart's kind of a pompous jerk, actually.
But he's not. That's why people aren't saying it. Ooh, Tucker, this is what you do. This is crossfire. Jon Stewart's watching and saying, of course you can.
Go ahead.
All I'm trying to say is it is a dangerous mistake to try to dismiss it the way you are. And this is, by the way, what conservatives have done to the press is said, oh, you can't trust them because they're liberal. This was not about political ideology. He was helping, literally, do the job for the press. Look, it doesn't make me happy that we can do this back in October and it doesn't have the kind of traction it does when he did
the
it.
The idea Jim Cramer's responsible for the meltdown? That's not journalism. That's demagoguery. That's stupid.
He didn't say they're responsible for the meltdown. He said CNBC and Jim Cramer and Rick Santelli are not doing their job as journalists.